Well, hello there, everybody, and welcome back to another War Thunder upcoming content video. Just by that little notification in the bottom right corner, you could tell that the computer just fucking started. Okay, no, it didn't. That I just opened up Bandicam, which means the computer started not too long ago. Hopefully I can get myself back on track in terms of a sleeping schedule from this point forward. Hopefully. I logged on to I responded to all these freaking comments and messages and stuff that I got on YouTube's towards the Sheridan. The Sheridan will not be able to go through the water, apparently. It needed like a flotation screen or something like that. But I was notified that there's actually a new reserve tank for the United States that will be able to go through the water. And that right there just, I mean, like, it was when my boner hit the bottom of the desk because it basically confirmed my suspicions of, will we finally be getting three reserve tanks for each nation, just as we had at least three reserve aircraft for each nation way back in the day? Or now, I don't know. Because there are technically four, but one of them you have to unlock and buy or something like that. Or now it's supposed to be exclusive. I don't know. Whatever. Who gives a shit? I don't remember. It's called the LVT or something like that. I haven't actually done any research on it, so I apologize if there's not much information here. But they showed off the Panzer III-B on the dev blog, so hopefully they'll show that off as well. And if they don't, then that's fine. You know, I'll just take a look at it in the overview once the patch actually goes live or update goes live, whatever. Yes, I've got food in front of me. I woke up just like about 10 minutes ago, and we went out to get something to eat, and I got myself a sub because. Refreshing. But anyways, I came back to see that there is actually another dev blog here posted for a new map. And that was anticlimactic. Right here. It is called okay. You know what? Who gives a shit what it's called? It looks awesome. This is actually my first time seeing it, so you know these are my first reactions. Okay, so it sounds like some Russian place. I've never heard of it. So, you know, being interested in a lot of World War II stuff and not hearing about a place like this, then I guess that goes to show what kind of knowledge I have. Anyways, let's go ahead and look at what the map has to provide, and then I'll kind of talk about my opinions and what kind of maps I want to see. So it's been a while since we've seen a new map. Okay, no, we've seen maps last update, I think. But I mean, it's been a while since we've seen a map in general, you know. And this one's going to be for mixed battles. Again, there's not going to be aircraft-only maps for a while. Gaijin stated on multiple occasions that they're focusing mostly on ground and mixed battle maps first because the aircraft already had a lot of maps to go by when the ground forces first came out. Okay, so we can see a few screenshots here, and it looks to be, just by first impressions, it looks like it's going to be a mix of urban combat, a mix of factory combat, like we haven't seen that yet, of what looks to be, well, maybe not factory combat, but more of what looks to be like a railroad with a lot of little warehouses and stuff here. We've got some shit going on here with crane. This is really cool to see because I don't think we've really any seen anything with this much detail in the game in terms of cranes. So that's kind of neat. It's gonna be the port of Novor. I don't know. Actually, come to think of it, is this the place? Just looking at it, is this the place for on the map? Fuck, you know, like Krimsk or whatever the hell it's called. The Kuban map, whatever the hell. Is this that port area where you got those big landing craft? Is that what? Because that's what it looks like to me. But whatever, forget about it. So it says we're pleased to present a new location for mixed battles, the port of Penis. This familiar location to War Thunder pilots has been given a spacious battlefield for ground vehicles. Okay, so it is something that we've been able to fly on before. We're pleased to present a new location for mixed battles, the port of Penis. In the autumn of 1943, Soviet troops broke through the heavily defended Axis line at the port with a daring landing attack. Oh, there you go, landing craft, under the dense artillery fire. This was one of the most successful joint operations of the Army, Air Force, and Navy. Oh, well then. Does that mean we'll be able to do the Navy here as well? You know, will this be one of those maps that where we can actually do ground vehicles, Navy, and aviation, which they pretty much said that we won't be getting? Sad face. And it played a decisive role in freeing the southern USSR from its occupation forces. We invite you to fight for the freight railroad terminal at the port of Penis. The War Thunder pilots are sure to recognize this location from the from the Cuban, I don't know how the fuck to pronounce that, and Crimean village missions. Like, apologize. Now it's time for tankers to enjoy or to join the fray. Our artists have done incredible work with the archive data, photographs, air photo intelligence data, and historical newsreels. Some rather exotic materials were used to produce this location, including a diagram of tramway lines from the early 40s and a set of pre-revolution postcards featuring views from Penis. As a result, we succeeded in recreating the city's harbor, the hero of Penis, and port, the freight railroad terminal, elevator, residential area, and the city park. Of course, we had to slightly alter the precise zone of military conflict so as not to provide a substantial advantage to one team or the other. Tank battles on the Penis map will take place for the control of a strategically important zones in the vicinity of the railroad terminal, city streets, and park. Players will fight in urban conditions. Oh. And among bombed-out residential areas and railroad warehouses. At the same time, the map allows for use of any tactic, from short-range brawls to sniper ambushes. The city also contains wide asphalt avenues for fast breakthroughs and a multitude of cover among ruined buildings, gullies, craters, and the remains of rail cars. Aircraft must destroy enemy ground targets with bombing runs to support the actions of their allies. That was pointless to put that in there because there's never going to be a formation of bombers to carpet bomb an area or perform bombing runs. No, that just doesn't happen in War Thunder, unfortunately. So as a map as a whole, I can't say right away, like usually I can say, "Oh, I really want this map. It's going to be my new favorite map." This definitely doesn't look like it's going to be my new favorite map at all. I mean, it looks cool. It's a unique location that we really haven't been able to play in so far. I still like the Stalingrad map, right? But what I'm sad about is that I wanted a fully urban Stalingrad map. You know, where you're fighting in the city, not in a tractor factory. So I'm hoping that we still get to see a map of the city sometime, because we've technically got two fully urban maps, but technically we've only got one fully urban map, Advance to the Rhine and Berlin. See, Berlin has this like 50 more than 50% of the map that isn't building. It's more of this clearing area, while Advance to the Rhine has, I would say, about, you know, maybe a 12% area of the map, which is just green hills in that like park area. Otherwise, it's all buildings that are crumbled or tall buildings. You know, that's why Advance to the Rhine is my favorite map, because I love urban combat. And when they put you in a situation where it's a fully urban map, which again, in your faces, for those of you who told me that War Thunder would never have fully urban maps, it still makes me laugh to this day. That's why I love that map so much. I mean, I'm not saying that every other map is shit, not at all. You know, I still like Poland and other maps that have urban areas but are mostly open. But for the most part, you know, I'm you know, I mean, I was kind of hoping for something that was going to be fully urban, and this doesn't really look like my kind of thing that I'm super excited for. I mean, warehouses and train yards, we've seen it already. Maybe not to this extent, but we've seen it for the most part in the I mean, we've seen a train here and there throughout some of the maps, but we've seen a lot of the whole train, you know, where there's multiple tracks and you have multiple train cars lined up or tipped over on the Stalingrad factory map. You know, so there's nothing new there. The warehouses, maybe. Maybe that's something new. The urban part is what I would be most intrigued by, and it looks like we've really the only thing that we get here are these two screenshots. Which, as you can see, is very urban-y, and I like that. I like this. The buildings are unique looking compared to what we've seen before. And this picture here gets to kind of show, like, I mean, this actually does, for the most part, kind of get me excited, because you can see all these little areas here that you can go. You've got this open area, this bridge. Oh, Gaijin, you've got to make maps with bridges more, please, because I love to have these big bridges, where everybody's fighting here and trying to get across the bridge. But it looks like we can come down here through the water and sneak up, and I think that would be really cool too. Maybe we can go down here and go off to the right and kind of sneak up and around, or vice versa. That kind of thing would be nice to see. So I mean, it looks fun, and I think we can see the train yards there in the background, so this could be one of the spawn areas over here. But again, it's not all urban, as it stated, because you can see in areas like this, it's going to be more open, and there's not going to be that many places to hide. In fact, this actually reminds me a lot of a World of Tanks map, which I don't know the name of course, but I'm pretty sure it'll be a fun map to play. Well, I mean, yeah, like I said, we haven't seen train yards to this extent. Not at all. So this is, I mean, it is something new, I guess I should say. But for the most part, I'm excited for it, but it's not what I was hoping for. Either way, every new map that doesn't look like shit is one map more that gives me less of a chance of getting Kursk. So I'm all for it. Let me know what you think down in the comments below of the new penis map, and what maps you guys would kind of like to see. I would really like to see some more desert maps. I mean, we've only got two right now. And I would also like to see, like I said, the Stalingrad actual city map. I would like to see one of those, and where you're actually battling in the just war-torn city. It just that would be awesome to see, or some other urban-y maps, or more so urban-y maps, or maybe an alternate Kursk map, so that we don't have to fight on the shitty, boring version of it. Something like that, which it's slightly less shitty and boring now that they have buildings. But it still didn't fix it for me, for the most part. It just slightly fixed it. And they lowered one of the hills, which makes it more fucking flat. Damn it, guys. Why would you do that? So, I want either an alternate Kursk map, or some more urban maps, or something like, kind of like this, where it's a mix of them, but a more colorful area. You know what I mean? Something along those lines. Or winter maps. I mean, you can never, you can, it, winter maps never get old for me. They never do. Frozen Pass, great map. Because there's only a couple urban villages in there, but it's mostly big hills and rock formations, and that performs somewhat like an urban area for me. And I mean, I just love the map. Anyways, guys, let me know what you think of this map in the comments below, of course. And also, if you've missed anything else, like I said, I mentioned the LVT, which hasn't been officially released on the dev blog yet. Other vehicles that have been announced, I'm just going to go through them quickly here. I'm not going to talk too much about them. I have covered each of these ones. The M551 Sheridan ATGM vehicle for the United States. The Cromwell 5 RP3 Premium Unguided Rocket Vehicle for the British. The Premium Westland Penis Aircraft for the British. The Jagdpanzer 4-5, which has lost its gun and has two mounted ATGM missiles. Well, that would be redundant to say. That's like saying, rip in peace. Are you fucking stupid? You're saying, rest in peace. Really? Anyways, this is for the Germans, their ATGM vehicle. The Russians are getting the ASU 85. The United States are getting a premium T-29 heavy tank. Germans are getting the Panzer III-B for their reserve. Russians are getting the ASU 57 for their tech tree, as well as the ASU 85. They are also have two premium KV-2s on the way, one for the Germans, a captured one, and a KV-2 with the ZIS-6 cannon for the Russians, which will also be a premium. Other aircraft and vehicles that were not officially released on the dev blog yet include the IT-1, which is the Russian ATGM, and the B-18 Bolo medium bomber for the United States Air Aviation. Along with the LVT that I mentioned before, there are still just a couple vehicles that haven't been released. They've been shown in live streams and screenshots, so they're pretty much confirmed, but they haven't been released on the official dev blog yet, and they include a Tier 4 tank destroyer, or I'm assuming a Tier 4 tank destroyer, open top for the Germans, which I'm not going to pronounce here. And also we have the Yak 30 for the Soviets, which is another aircraft, a jet aircraft. And also there has been talk of, I believe, is that everything? I think that might be everything for right now. If I miss something, I apologize. And also it's been brought to my attention that there's apparently also a new like kind of feature that's being added, the med kit feature, which will allow you to apparently bring back one of your crew members. I think that this could work, but honestly, I mean, in the middle of battle, yeah, it could work. But honestly, I still want the ability to go back to a friendly capture zone and replenish all of my crew at some point. That kind of thing has got to happen, because that's what happened in real life when a tank crew either lost somebody or lost a lot of their people, but not enough to where they would bail out. They would continue until a checkpoint or until they the they met up with their forces or something, and then they would have their crew replaced, something along those lines, if the tank wasn't too damaged, that is. But of course, like we've talked about in the past, in a real situation, if the tank's turret was jammed, yeah, the crew's gonna bail out or gonna sit there and die, because it's not as simple as War Thunder. One does not simply repair the turret being jammed or put some tracks back on in the middle of combat. That just doesn't happen. Or just, should I say, didn't happen. Anyways, guys, new map location. It's exciting. At first, when I saw this, I thought it was an airfield, not a crane. Because doesn't it kind of look like an airfield on a port? And I was like, finally, we're getting some new Pacific Theater maps. Because we've only got one in the game, the jungle map. That's it. We don't have any others. Obviously, because the Japanese aren't on the way yet. But that's what I was hoping for. I was hoping it would be one of the Pacific Theater Islands, and that was one of the airfields, and we'd be able to fight and drive across the airfield. Oh, that would be awesome. But I'm sure we'll see some more Pacific Theater maps when the Japanese ground forces start coming around. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next War Thunder video.